Hello. Previously, on the Vision of Escaflowne Retrospective. Alan had a pretty unpleasant childhood, owing mostly to the fact that his father, a character I actively hate and had a 5-minute rant recorded about, which I can post if you'd like, mentioned in the Alan video that there was a rant about his father prepared that I cut out because it was part of the 35-minute script, which honestly I didn't feel like editing. I'm glad I went with the condensed version, as I said basically the same thing. However, in order to condense it down to 22 minutes, I did have to cut out my rant on how I feel about Leon, i.e. Alan's dad. It is gonna be in here. That is the point of this video, since some people thought it might be interesting to hear my thoughts on the character. However, instead of this just being a little meme rant, which it will be after this prelude, I wanted to say that my main problem with the character is not the idea of a deadbeat dad, or the idea of a guy just being a failure to his family. Unfortunately, that does happen. The reason I don't like Leon is because they treat this guy like he's a saint, even though he's kind of thrown away his entire life to simp for a woman whom he met like for a combined 20 minutes and seemed kind of uncomfortable being around him. I mean, note, the woman he's chasing, Hitomi's grandmother, never actually says anything in the scenes she shares with him. She kind of just looks uncomfortably at this guy who's traveling all this way to find her. Anyways, that's why I don't like Leon. Not because of the concept, but because of the way he's handled. They handle this guy who ran out on his family like some kind of great hero, even though he's not. He's just kind of a loser in my eyes, and a selfish one at that. Anyways, with the constructive part of this video out of the way, let's get to why we all came here. Quick tangent on Alan's father. I think I hate this character more than any other character I've seen in any of the series I've reviewed on this channel. There are a few characters that I've hated, or I don't know, hate's a strong word, I've disliked. Daedalus from Ergo Proxy is a good example. I did not like his character. For the most part, I didn't care for them because it seemed like the writers didn't quite know what they were doing, or because they were intentionally written to be dislikable. Daedalus is a great example of this. Why I don't like his character, it's pretty obvious that you're not supposed to, because Daedalus is kind of like the, hey, don't be like this character. I get it. He's not supposed to be likable. And it's written very obviously. The show is saying, don't be like this guy. This guy sucks. So I have no idea why VoE decided to portray Alan's father the way he did. His dad just runs off so he could, quote, be his own man or some flimsy BS about making fate or whatever. And I just hate how the show portrays this because, yes, I understand that making your own destiny is a key theme of the series, of yes, you gotta use your agency to make yourself who you want to be. I get it, that's a key theme of the series. However, we're supposed to feel bad for this guy because he died alone, because he decided to abandon his loving wife, because it's how he rebelled against fate or something? Like this guy is still unlikable and self-absorbed to me. Like, I don't understand how I'm supposed to feel about this character. I mean, it's obvious that, you know, I would think most people don't like Leon because he's kind of, he just ran out on his family and kind of screwed everyone over. Again, but it seems like the show wants us to forgive this man and feel bad for him, but I don't feel bad for this guy. Like, what has he done? What has he done that I should feel bad for him for? He's abandoned his family. Why did he do that? He did that because he needed to go make his fate and talk to some woman who doesn't even talk back and seems vaguely uncomfortable in his presence. Great job, Leon. You destroyed your family for that. Okay, this guy's no Hohenheim. He's not going out to save the kingdom. He's not even going out to get Arby's or something. He's just bailing to bail, I guess. He says this to make his fate. Oh, I gotta prove my destiny. But, you know, I don't know why that requires screwing over everyone else in your life. You could make the argument that, hey, this is his passion. Whatever. If that's the case, why don't you talk to your wife about it? Because if she loves you, and apparently you guys love each other, allegedly, I'm pretty sure she would be supportive enough of this to either go with you or to not be horribly traumatized if you just said, hey, I gotta do this thing. Yeah. Yeah, no, bailing unexpectedly with no contingency or support plan left over for when you do that is the best possible option. Good job, Leon. Again, they set up this character. All of his actions set him up to be, like, despised, or at the very least, like, ah, man, what a douche. But for some reason, the show is like, man, this guy had a tragic life. This guy's he sacrificed so much. He's doing all he can, but he's not. He's doing all he can to screw over his family. Like, again, with every character in the series, Escaflowne does a good job of saying, here's the facts,
Here's what this character does. Here's how they behave. Here's a few of their opinions on things. You decide if you like that character or not. Every character kind of follows this pattern. Alan is a deconstruction of fantasy, yeah, but you can tell that that's kind of the point. However, the show never says if he's a good or bad person. Vaughn is kind of impulsive and learning to be a good king, but whether or not he is by the end of the series is left for you to decide. The show is pretty generous with allowing you to come to your own decisions about how you feel about certain characters. You may still hate Falcon because he did work for Dornkirk, or you may say, you know what, he kind of got screwed over. I feel bad for this guy, you know. Or maybe the exact opposite. Maybe you hate Alan because he does exhibit some weird personality traits. And again, the show's pretty good about just letting the characters be themselves and saying, you decide how you want to feel about it. Every character except Leon, like this guy. I think it's pretty obvious that I don't like him. And I would assume that a lot of people don't either, because again, running out on your family to go simp for a woman whose name you don't even know is, I would think, not generally considered respectful behavior. So it seems like the show is setting up this character to be hated, or at the very least, like, not liked, serve as some kind of warning, like, hey, don't be like this guy. But again, I don't know what they want us to think in this case, because when Leon has his talk with Alan, Alan forgives him out of, like genuinely forgives him and feels bad for him, and I guess we're supposed to too. Like, it's one thing if Alan's like, hey man, you know, I gotta forgive you, I can move on with my life, close that chapter of the book. I wouldn't understand that. I don't understand, like, legitimately feeling bad for him, though, because he kind of did this to himself, and in the process of doing so, screwed over everyone else vaguely, tangentially related to him. Like, if I was in Alan's situation, I would say, you know what, I'm not talking to you, whatever, we're done, I can move on with my life. I feel like that's what a well-adjusted person would make in this scenario. I'm not a doctor, other than, like, complete reconciliation, which, I mean, you can't because he's literally a ghost by this point, but that's besides the point. The point is, Escaflowne seems like it wants us to feel bad for this guy, and I really can't because he really kind of just made a bunch of decisions that made no sense and were all very obviously net negatives, and I can't support that kind of reckless behavior, dude. Like if you were solo and whatever, I guess, yeah, go do your thing, but the fact that you left your wife without any form of support, without even telling her that you were going to do this great quest. Like, I don't believe you when you say you love her, because if you loved her, you wouldn't do that kind of thing. Yeah, so I don't like this character because his actions portray him as a scumbag. And the reason he confuses me so much is because Escaflowne says he's not a scumbag, or it seems like it wants to say that. Again, there's nothing wrong with a show having scummy characters. If the whole point is either don't be like this guy, or to establish them as scumbags so that we don't like them, that's fine. But Escaflowne establishes this guy as kind of scummy or weird or dumb or whatever. Then it says, let's forgive this man. He is a good man. I can't believe he's a good man in this scenario. That's the problem. I can't believe that. And it's very uncharacteristic for the show to tell the viewer how to feel about a character, because I don't think it does it with literally any other character except Leon. And maybe I didn't watch the scenes correctly. I've seen them, like, again, like 7 times. Or maybe I'm having a brain fart. But I don't know why we're supposed to feel bad for this guy. And it's one of the few tonal and writing decisions about this series that just baffles me to no end. You make an unlikable character, and then you handle him like we're supposed to like him or feel bad for him. It just makes me confused and dislike him more. Like, what was the point of this?
For some reason, Alan's dad is cast as sort of, like, space Jesus? I'm so sorry, Lord. But, you know, like, the tale of Alan's family is tragic, yes. But only because this asshat ran off. Like, he's not tragic. He's not smart. He's just a... Yeah, like he says some BS about, like, oh, I only married out of duty or whatever. But that's it, dude. Like you committed. And this woman loves you, and you allegedly love her. You bitch about how you miss her, even though you are the one that decided to go on this dumbass quest, literally for no other reason than to see some other woman. Like, you, man.
I will get back to serious production soon. The Vaughn episode should still be up sometime in the next few days, in accordance with the vaguely weekly upload schedule. Thanks for tuning in.